What's up, Raging Nation? How's it going? This is Alex Yu. You're watching the Raging Runner review. I got a review for you. Last Thursday, I watched Exodus. And Exodus is the latest film from director Ridley Scott. Ridley Scott is a director that I put in my top 10 favorite directors of all time. So I was definitely looking forward to this movie. Now, the movie that I've watched from Ridley Scott before Exodus is, of course, his 2013 film, The Counselor. That was a terrible film. Now here comes 2014 with Exodus, and this is his time to redeem himself. Alright, so I was definitely looking forward to this film. And on top of that, this is a film which brings Ridley Scott back to a genre that he likes to revisit, and that is the Sword and Sandals epics. By Sword and Sandals epics, I'm talking about films like Gladiator, Kingdom of Heaven, Robin Hood, and now Exodus. And I have to say that out of all four of these films, Exodus is his weakest. This movie kind of falls flat, unfortunately, and I'm going to explain to you how it does that. This movie is about the story of Moses, and if you're not familiar with the story of Moses, like myself, all I know is that he parts the Red Sea. That's all I know. I've never read the source material, so I'm just going to take this movie like a Swords and Sandals epic, okay? And what it really is about is Moses communicating with God and, you know, talking about how he wants to go back into the city that he was exiled from so that he can banish all the evil. Like, a lot of sins are taking place in this city where he used to rule with his brother. But there's a lot of sins going on, and he wants to free slaves, all right? And he's going to God for advice, and looking to God for just how he can do this. And that's pretty much the story. But then God, he unleashes his form of justice, and then you know, that's how the movie plays out, right? I mean, it's essentially a biblical epic, but it doesn't feel like a biblical epic. It feels like two films, and that is what I find is the problem with this film. It feels like it's a very bipolar theatrical experience. I mean, you would get a big action sequence in the beginning of the movie, which is, you know, pretty cool. But, you know, great cinematography, but nothing really we haven't seen before. And then not a whole lot in between. You get some gimmicky visual effects moments. And then you have like this big sequence at the end of the movie, which was very, very anticlimactic and in some ways very unsatisfying. That's how this movie feels bipolar. It feels like two different films. It feels like it wants to be a biblical epic, but in actuality, it's a visual effects driven swords and sandals. I won't even call it an epic because I don't feel it was epic at all. I felt that there's a lot of pacing issues because the movie is just really, really boring at the beginning of the movie. It doesn't really pick up until you know, it just somewhat picks up after Moses gets exiled. Everything that takes place in Egypt or wherever they are, it's in Egypt. They have the pyramids and the sphinxes. Everything that takes place in there before Moses gets exiled is actually quite boring. There's just no substance there. You have actors, like supporting actors, like Sigourney Weaver, Ben Kingsley, John Turturro, and they're just there, but they don't really need to even be there. they're there just for like for show. I don't see any reason why they need to cast like these Hollywood heavyweights like Sigourney Weaver and Ben Kingsley when they were hardly even in the movie with just a few moments of dialogue. So I don't know what's going on with Ridley Scott. I mean, it's two for two already. The Counselor was a very poor film. This movie really, really tries too hard to be a good film. In fact, I would say that it doesn't even try hard enough. Okay? It just has a lot of problems. And most of it is just really not knowing what direction it's going in. Like, this feels like two different movies. is like it's very visually driven in the middle of the movie, or in the like the almost near the in, around the second act of the film, and then it's just really, really boring with a very slow pace. Nothing actually happens, with a lot of just going back and forth and a lot of mundane dialogue. Joel Edgerton, an actor that I really, really like and admire, he plays the villain in the movie. I forgot his name, but I think he does a very good job. In fact, he might be the one with the best performance. I wouldn't say it's Christian Bale. I would say that there's nothing here that really, really feels that makes the movie that great, except for some great cinematography, as well as some cool action sequences which involve a lot of soldiers. You know, it's a very visually driven film. Some really unique visual effects moments involving animals and insects, and these are the things which make the movie very, very exciting and, you know, fun to watch, right? But everything else just feels like it's just hard to really connect with. All right, I really enjoyed Noah a lot more. I thought Noah was a very good film. I don't think it was an amazing film, but it was a very good film. Okay. Despite some problems in the third act. But I think that Exodus is a film that really has problems everywhere throughout the film. And that's really unfortunate. And I think that Ridley Scott is kind of losing it. I think he should go back to films like Blade Runner, you know, that make that Blade Runner sequel, work in that Prometheus sequel. But I think that he should stop going back to the Sword and Sandals epics. Ridley Scott has done a lot of other great films. For example, Black Hawk Down, American Gangster, Alien, of course. But I don't think this is a genre that he needs to revisit. Gladiator was his great film, all right? Kingdom in Heaven and Robin Hood were okay at best. But Exodus is a movie in that genre that really does not need to have been made by him. All right. And that's all I got to say in this video. This review is pretty much telling you that I don't recommend this movie. I can't recommend this movie. I think that you'll be snoozing in this movie, because it's quite boring. It's a very slow-paced movie, and the characters are not interesting enough for you to stay that engaged with them. You're really just waiting for the next time they're gonna go into battle, which takes a while to get there, all right, unfortunately. So there you have it. That's all I gotta say in this movie. I am gonna give this movie a 4 out of 10 for effort, but for the most part, the best parts about it is really the cinematography and the visuals, alright? So there you have it, that's all I gotta say in this video. As always, if you enjoyed this video, hit the like button, subscribe to the YouTube channel, like me on Facebook, The Raging Nation, also follow me on Twitter, @RagingNation. My name is Alex, thanks for watching, I'll see you next time, peace. And that tells you something. That tells you that, you know, if they don't want to answer the question, and that means that there's a reason why they're not...